Hey guys, I got some questions about if I can make a tutorial for the logic gate and the stuff with that. Yeah, I can try it, but first of all, keep in mind, logic has many ways to achieve what you want, so what I show you is not the only one way. There are many different ways, many other people do that in other ways, so if you want a good example for logic, please don't show, look only one tutorial, please look more, because there are many different ways, but some are better, some are slower, some are not so expensive, different types. So it depends on what situation you have and what you need, and yeah. So it's a little bit hard to explain what there is all, because you can make out of the logic gates basically a functional computer, a PC in the game. Yeah, the game will run very slow, and the PC that you build too, but yeah, you can make everything if you want and have enough time. So I will show you first the basic gates and what they do. So we have the gate, and if you open that, we have six types of gates. If we are correct, there are seven, because you can use one of them here as an inverter and not gate. So not gate does basically nothing else, inverts the incoming signal. So if you have a button that is on, it inverts the signal to off, and if the button is off, then it inverts the signal off to on. So that is basically a NOT gate, and that can, this gate here can act like a NOT gate if you make it one of them, and only with a single connection in and a single connection out. That is the important part on that. Then you have a NOT gate. So that NOT gate is the first gate of all. Then we have the AND gate. The AND gate is very simple. I will use some switches and buttons, or maybe a sensor later, and the lights here as indicators to see which state the gates have. So, for an AND gate, for example, you can wire one button has that is useless. If you use an AND gate with one button, if one button is on, then the output is on. So if you use that only one button, make it so, and don't use gates, because you see, it would be very stupid if you make that. An AND gate does follow one rule: if all inputs on, the output will on. Only in that case, if all inputs, everything what is connected to the gate, if all of that is on, then only then the light will turn on. You can see, okay, nothing happens. Only if all four are on, it will turn on. You can remove two, but there is no, only if all inputs, in this case two, are on, then the output is on. That is very simple. Then we have the OR gate. Yeah, that is similar to the AND gate, but not if all on, only if one is on. It will turn on every time. Even if you turn both on, it will go on. But keep in mind, if for example two inputs connected to the OR gate, you need to deactivate both inputs to turn that off again. Very important. So then we have the XOR gate. XOR. The XOR gate is very handy for a situation like you have a light in a big room, and you have many switches at the doors. For example, we make the example here. We have the lights here, and we want, for example, switches by the doors to turn off the room light. Every by every door. So I will put one gate here. Make that to an XOR. And connect the lights to that. And the switches, all of them to the XOR gate. So, you see? The state of the switches by an XOR is not important. On or off doesn't mean that that state is on or off. That is a special case. So I can turn off on the lights here. I can go here and can turn off. I can turn it on. The same here. On every door. Like for example, I can turn it on here. Can walk here. Can turn it off. So that is very useful in this case. For example, you have a big staircase. At the bottom floor you have a switch, and at the top floor you have a switch, and you can turn on the light if you go into the stairs and go up, and then you can turn it off with another button or switch. So that is very useful, the XOR gate. Then we have the, let me look, the NAND gate. How I said before, the NAND or the NOR or the XNOR can act like an inverter, like a NOT gate. I will show you that. NAND. The switch is off, the gate is on, the lamp is on. I turn it off, I turn the switch on, the gate goes off, the light goes off. Just an inverter. And for the NAND, the rules are very similar to the AND gate, only with an inverted output. So the NAND gate is nothing else like an AND gate with a NOT at the back. So the output of the AND gate will be inverted, and that is the output of the NAND gate. So you see? If not all inputs are on, the light will on. If all inputs are on, the state will be off of the gate. So that is a good, for example, if you have a detection system for walls or something like that, you can hook up the engine to it, and if a sensor detects the wall, it will turn on, and yeah, you can control something like that, something with that, very useful. I have not many cases where I need a NAND, so that is especially a NAND. I use that most of the time as a NOT gate and not like an AND gate. So that is this. The NOR gate is the same like an OR gate, very similar, but like by the NAND gate, the output is inverted. So you can see, only if all inputs are off, the light will on. In any other case, the light is off. So if any input is on, the light goes off. It is a very good control circuit. So you can make like sensors on your wall, and if somewhere an enemy hits a sensor, for example, the state will turn, will switch, and you know exactly, there is an enemy. That is for only an example. So, and then we have the XNOR gate. Yeah, that is very similar to the what was the name? XOR gate, only with the inverted signal. That is like here. You can change that, but then the default state is off. So that is basically the same. only with the output inverted. Huh? See? Does nothing else. So that is the one. That is the basic gates. I hope that was good to understand. So there are some cases where you need a switch, but you can't use a switch because you can't reset the state from elsewhere. So we must make a switch with gates, and for that you can use the NOR gate. NOR, and this one must one of them. Or the best is just use the AND, so you don't need to change something. The problem is why we need three gates is you can't connect one gate to, for example, that is gate R, gate A, and that is gate B. So we can connect A to B, but then we can't connect B to A back, because that removes the connection. So we need a third gate, so we can make a loop like this. That is a bit stupid from the developer to let not us make that, but it works like that, so we must use a third gate. So we set that to a NOR gate, and that to a NOR gate, and that can be an AND gate. That is not important, that is only a bridge to make the loop. So then we have, for example, two buttons. One is to turn off the toggle, that is like on or off. So that will make this. Just connect them to here, and I will use a lamp as an indicator. So you can see what happens. I press here, nothing. I press here, it switches the state back. I can press the button again and nothing happens. I can switch it back here. It will hold the state. Like a switch. But we can activate it from elsewhere with many buttons, and we can deactivate it with one click back. So that is a toggle state logic, or in 1-bit memory if you want. So then what is next? Maybe I can show you what you can make with AND gates. Let me go out. For example, the door. Sometimes you want to have buttons on both sides to open and close the same door. Then take a switch, place it by the door, go to place a logic gate, make it to an XOR gate, connect that to the gate and to the controller that is controlling your door. If you press it, the door goes open. Take a second switch and connect that to the XOR gate too, and we can open and close the door from both sides. See? That is one more example for XNOR. And for an AND gate is a good example a spot gun Gatling we need for sensors that activates like a button, and we need four AND gates because if we press the shoot button we don't want that all spot guns at the same time fire. We want only the bottom one that is shooting if it's spinning. For that are the AND gates and the sensors and the button. So we link the button to all AND gates. Because of the rule from the AND gate, if all inputs are on, then the output is on too. So in this case we have one input from the button to all. Let me show you maybe where is... Ah, here. There's the front, you can see. If I press the button, the gates goes on. All gates goes on. I should rotate the other two, but they are on too. So, but currently they have only one single input, so that means if I press the button, the input is on, so the output is on. Now I will connect the sensors to the direct gate behind it. So in this case, that sensor to this. So the AND gate has now two inputs, one of the button and one of the sensor, and only if both is on, then the output of the gate will on. So just make that with the other gates and link each gate to one of the butt guns. It's a bit hard to see, sorry, but that is not important. Gatling is not the tutorial here. This must be here. So now it is so, if I press the button, for example, this gate will not go on only if the sensor hits the pole here or me. So then the butt gun will shoot. See, only the bottom one shoots. Because the sensor, you can see the green light, goes on in the same time where I hold the button down. Oh, that is the function of the Gatling. And use for an AND gate. So that is this. What is more? Ah! In some cases you don't need this behavior from buttons, because you hold it down and it stays on. Sometimes you need only a short pulse and not this after holding. So, and if you need something like that, you can use one AND gate and one NAND gate. Just connect the button to the NAND and the button to the AND. Then the NAND to the AND. Okay? It's a bit hard. And for the indication, we need the light. So, the rule here is the NAND acts like NOT gate, an inverter. So, it makes the signal from the button inverted. So, in this case, the button is off, so that signal is on. This is an AND gate. So, and it has two inputs. So that means if this is on and the button is on, only then the output will be on. So for here, if I press it, it goes on and this is on. So for a one tick, it will turn on. But exactly in that moment, the NAND gate, the inverter, will invert the on state to off, and the AND gate has not both inputs anymore on. So that is off, that is on, so the output will be off. Like this. It doesn't care how long I hold the button, it stays off. But it has a short pulse. What you can do for this with this is, for example, if you press a button connected to a timer, and let me, you see, that's a little bit too much, like so, fill up, yeah. For the time I hold that, the timer gets longer, so you can see that. And that is sometimes a problem, because it stays on for the time. You can see the bars in the timer. Yeah, I can show you that. I press short. Maybe make that a little bit shorter. So. And the light will turn on very short. Okay. If I hold that, it will turn on for the time I have hold the button. That is sometimes not so useful. So if you connect that then to a timer now, what we made before here, the short pulse setup. Let me change that to 5. So if you press the button now, it doesn't care how long you see only a single bar in the timer and a short pulse. Every time. We have here, okay, you can spam it a lot to get more, but you can't hold it to produce more. So you saw the little, every time I tapped, the light will turn on exactly in the same pattern. You saw? It is like a delay. So, that is a short pulse. Yeah, and I think that is for now all what I can show you. The video is long enough now, and I hope you have a little bit now a hint what you can make with logic gates. Yeah, and don't forget, there are many different ways how you can use them, what you can make with that, and that gets very quick, very complex. So just train with it. If you have problems, then use it more and you will get that to work what you want. So, in this case, thanks for watching. I hope you like that and I hope it helps a little bit. And yeah, we see you soon. Maybe with a new video or with the next stream. I'm not sure. So, bye bye guys. See you next time.